All right, I'm back. Back with my live carving session. I am working on this little brainchild monster. He is being carved out of MDF, medium density fiberboard. You're joining me. This is the start of the second hour of this project. And it's kind of working along. If you have any questions or anything that you want to say or ask, please do. And I'm just going to work along and carve up this little brainchild monster piece, which is the last in this little series of monsters that I'm currently working on. Have I ever tried another technique like collagraphia? I've done a lot of techniques. I'm not specifically sure what that collagraphia. Is it a collagraph? Probably in English. I'm not entirely sure what that translates to, but I have knowledge of collagraphs. I've never done it, but I understand how they basically work. I do have experience in screen printing, I have experience in etching, I have experience in dry point, I have experience in lithography, a little bit of experience in lithography. But mostly, I'm working with woodcut. Out of all those other printmaking processes, my second favorite process was an intaglio etching. Thought of a lot of things that you can do. Adding a little bit of shadow here underneath this jaw on this side, and then I'm gonna carve a clean line the rest of the way over. Carve around the top edge of this lobster claw. And then clear out this little area of torso between the chin and the lobster claw. Got my U gouge to clear it out. carve out this hand before I go any further on the belly.
Starting to get a little confused down there. I'm working towards this hand. Hello, hello. Clear out this area, his little bicep here. Clear that out. I just looked down at his toes for the first time in a while. I forgot that I gave him little monster toes, little talons. Should have put like fur on the back of his hand, maybe. Yeah. Next time I do a little lobster-handed baby brain monster thing. Bit of information that I want to save in that one, so I'm going to come back to that when I have my V-gouge in my hand. I can take it from here up, though. I've got that arm done. I can kind of come under here and get this taken care of. and then also up here. I'm gonna zigzag this one.
Zigzag is one of my favorite things to do. Let me do this curve though.
That's a nice little curve. Yeah, it's not gonna be straight lines like I've drawn. I'm gonna zigzag it. And if you don't know what I mean by that, hang on for a minute. While I clear this out, and I'll show you. Zigzag. I'm just gonna cut my V gouge about halfway through this mark. And then I'm gonna double back and go between the cuts to create a zigzag. See? Zigzag. No, I enjoy a zigzag. This one's gonna be straight lines though. Alright. Belly button time. Instead of the belly button, be careful, careful, careful. He's got an Audi. I didn't know why that was going to be funnier than an Andy, but I like drawing Audi belly buttons. Alright, so his little Audi's done. And now I gotta get the gray section that's on the underside of his pooch there. Taken care of. Outline the hand. And then I got quite a bit of clearing to do on him. Almost done with that line on the hand. His little nubby baby fingers. And one more little outline of the hand bit. Round off that knuckle. And get ready. Clear it out. Clear it out. Get out of here. I don't need you. You can't tell what it is. It's a monster. Let's see if I can get it more up. It's a monster. A little brain-headed monster thing. I call him Brainchild. Because he's a baby that has a brain, and it's kind of punny. So. There you go. Gotta get the lines under the poochie belly. Under the diaper. Thank you. Hello, hello. Thank you. Thank you.
All right.
So last little bit of the diaper.
I gotta still do that part.
But I get the front end of these frills carved away.
Front end frills,
backside frills, backside frills. All right, one more backside frill. How long does each piece usually take? So this one I've been working on, I guess, for about an hour and a half, maybe about an hour 45. It's hard to say so far. And I've probably got another 20 to 30 minutes carving.
And then I've got to paint it.
And painting it will probably take an hour at least tonight to do it. And the inking takes like, 5 minutes to ink the surface. So each piece, and it takes a pretty good bit of time. And that doesn't even take into account the planning and the drawing out and the sketching and the getting it on the board and the cutting out each piece into the shape of the board. So it's really hard to say exactly how long each piece takes. But a safe estimate is like between 5 and 10 hours for each piece, depending on the size, obviously. Some sketches take longer than others. The planning stages are usually what takes the most time. With the carving taking a couple hours each. All right, now I gotta get this little monster legs going. I need to get some. Once I got these monster legs, we's done. How long have I been doing this? I've been carving wood, I guess, for probably about 10 years now, to be honest with you. Was when I first did one of my wood carving pieces, or one of my relief print pieces. I started when I was an undergrad. And I graduated about 7 years ago, but I was in school for 4 years. What kind of wood do I use? Because it sounds so crispy and fragile. Well, I use MDF. It's not very fragile because know, it's really solid. It's not soft. I've just been carving for a while, so I'm good at it. But it's definitely not fragile. These claws will be fun to paint. Actually, let's see. One last leg, which is good because my palm's starting to hurt from a little bit of carving, too much carving. You've been doing this for a long time. That's why it looks very easy, but I've tried myself and I still can't figure out what I'm doing.
Yeah, I mean, so I went to school for this. I went to school for art. I know for and I went to school for drawing, painting, and printmaking. I know a lot of different processes, and I know printmaking is very technical. And there's a lot of troubleshooting, and the more experience you have, pretty much with anything, really, the easier it's going to be for you to figure out when things aren't working right. So I would, you know, go take a class, go talk to someone in real life. Who can help you? But yeah, it just takes a lot of practice, man. Well, what got me into this? I went to school for it. I was introduced to printmaking, or woodcut, in my first printmaking class. I did a linoleum carving and really enjoyed the process. So I stuck with it.
Little Bailey. Hi, little Bailey. Thank you for the kind words, man. I'm gonna leave that little bit there. I was gonna carve that little black line away, but I'm gonna leave that there. It's kinda nice. Alright. Now for the little claws. And then I'll be done. So I am planning on probably gonna take a step back and go get enjoy my evening and go get some dinner and maybe go hang out somewhere tonight. But I am planning on coming back on tonight around probably 11 o'clock
and painting this guy. And I also, for the first time ever, I will do a live inking session of this guy. So I'll do a live painting session with him, and then I will let him dry and come back like 30 minutes after that or so, and then do a live inking session 30 to 45 minutes after that. So if you are able to come back around, I'd say like 11 o'clock, maybe a little later, maybe a little earlier, watch me paint them. And then probably about 12:30 or so, I will be doing a live inking of him tonight too. And all those times are Eastern Standard Times, so. So thank you guys for, the wood is MDF. Alright, so thank you guys for watching and hanging out with me as I carve this little guy up. He is finished. See if I can get most of him in the screen. He is finished. He's done. And he's ready to paint. So come back and check that out later tonight, okay? Thank you for watching. I'm going to be signing off now.